गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर द आउटकम्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी। एज वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर अबाउट द मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशन ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, द डेमोक्रेसी इज अ इंग्लिश वर्ड विच ड्राइव्ड फ्रॉम द टू लेटिन वर्ड डिमोस प्लस क्रेटिया। डिमोस मीन्स पीपल एंड क्रेटिया मीन्स रूल और पावर। सो इन सिंपल मीनिंग ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इज that rule of people or power of people is known as democracy. Then we discussed the most beautiful definition of democracy, which was given by Abraham Lincoln, that democracy is a form of government for the people, of the people, and by the people. Another definition which was given by Garner, that democracy is a form of government in which representatives are elected by the people. So students, in this chapter we discuss that what are the outcomes, what are the results of the democratic procedures and democratic government, which aspects we are demanding from democracy. All aspects we are discussing in this chapter. So let us start our chapter, that outcomes of democracy. The chapter discusses about the outcomes that can be reasonably expected of a democracy and actual outcomes of democracy in various respects. The democratic government is looking very good, but when we see in actual life, it is not so good because there are lot of lacks in the democratic government, by which we can feel that it is not so good in principle. But still, more than 3/4 of the world countries, they are accepted and following the procedures of democracy. Why democracy is a better form of government when we compared with dictatorship or any other alternative? Define dictatorship. It is a form of government in which all the powers are vested in a single hand. For example, North Korea, Kim Jong-un is the dictator of North Korea. But in democracy, people are the ruler themselves. So when we discuss about the importance of democracy, so many people, they spotted democracy because it is a better form of government. Why? These are the 5 points which shows the importance of democracy, that why it is better than others. It promotes equality among citizens. As we know that in our country India, the fundamental rights are given by our Indian Constitution from Article 12 to 35. Right to equality, which is given by Article 14 to 18. So these fundamental rights, they promote equality among citizens. Like political equality, every person who is 18 and above has right to vote and he can contest in the elections. This is political equality, rule of law, that is, nobody is above the law and everyone is equal before the eyes of law. All these fundamental rights promote equality among citizens. Enhances the dignity of the individual. As we know that in a democratic government, people are the ruler themselves. They elect their representatives and those representatives take decision on the behalf of the people. Improves the quality of decision making. It is fact that there are some delays in decision making, but the decision which are taken by the democratic government, they are acceptable to the people. It provides a method to resolve conflict in peaceful manner, and it allows a room to correct mistakes. There is only one room in democratic countries or in a democracy in which the mistakes are accepted and correct by the government of that country. These 5 points shows that how democracy is much better form of government as compared to others. The next concept, that how do we assess democracy's outcomes? We generally face this dilemma. Democracy is seen to be good in principle but felt to be not so good in its practice. It means that In first look, democracy is the best form of the government, but when we study about the democratic government, that what are the economic outcomes, what are the social outcomes, political outcomes of democratic country, then we feel some disappointment that what are the outcomes of a democratic government. So let us start that first of all, the democratic government is also known as accountable government, responsive and the legitimate government. Let us discuss one by one. First, we discuss about the accountable form of government. Accountable government is a government which is answerable or which is required to justify its action or decision. Why the democratic government is known as accountable form of government? Because it is the people's own government. It is elected by the people and it is ruled over the people according to their wishes. Democratic government is answerable to the people or the parliament. The Indian government is answerable to the parliament because the government is formed by that political party that has majority in the lower house of parliament. In democracy, people elect their representatives who form government, and if they do not working according to the wishes of the people have right to change them. Yes, it is fact about democracy that the people, they form the government, they elected representatives, because India has representative form of democracy, and if these representatives are not working as the desire of the people, then they remove them through the next election. For example, Indian government is answerable to the parliament. So these are the some points which show that democratic government is a accountable form of government. Next, that responsive government. Responsive government is a government which responds positively to the needs and aspirations of the people. What people wants, there is a focus of a responsive government, of a democratic government. The government takes decisions, form policies which are acceptable to the people. If the policies are not acceptable to the people, if the people they raise their voice against the policies, bad policies of the government, then the government has to take back its decision and remove all the evils from that decisions. Under this, whenever possible and necessary, citizens can participate in the decision making. Next is legitimate government. Democratic government is ruling over the country by some sets of rules and laws which are mentioned in the Indian constitution or any country's constitutions. So, democratic government is known as legitimate government. That legitimate government is a government which works according to a set of rules. That is, government takes decision by following norms and a proper procedure which is given by the country's constitution. Citizens are free to know if a decision was taken through a proper procedure. This is known as transparency. It is the biggest disadvantage of a democratic country or a democratic government, that people are free to take the information regarding the decision of the government, and this process is known as transparency. What is transparency? That if the citizens are free to know if a decision was taken through a proper procedure, that process is known as transparency. For example, in India, the government has provided citizens Right to Information Act. This act was enforced in 2005, which empowers the people to find how the government is working. So this is the weapon in the hands of Indian people to know that the decisions which are taken by the government of India by a correct procedure or not, that is Right to Information Act. So these 3 points shows that why the democratic government is known as accountable, responsive and legitimate government. Next, there are some actual outcomes and the practices and institutions to measure democracy, that on which basis we are measuring the democratic outcomes, but what is the real condition of these outcomes. The first one is regular, free and fair election. It is the first condition of a democratic country that there are regular, free and fair election. But the actual outcomes in India, that regular and free elections are held but fall short of providing fair chance to everyone. You know that a rich people has always an advantage over the poor people when they contest in the election. Open public debate on major policies. It is the second most important practice or institution to measure about democracy, but it falls short of setting up condition for open public debate. In our country, India, there is no proper facility to held the proper debate on the major policies of the Indian government. Citizens' right to information, which was given in 2005 by the Indian government, but it has not a very good record when the people they are demanding and they want to take any information regarding the processing of the government. So it is not a very good record that the government is providing in a proper way to the people what the people want. Attentive to the needs of the people. A democratic government must be attentive to the needs of the people, but often frustrate the needs of the people. They do not care the needs of the people and ignore the demands of the majority of its. And next, and the most important, that free of corruption. Yes, must be free of corruption, but the real outcome is the routine tales of corruption. From 2004 to 2014, during the UPA government, there was a tales of corruption, 2G scam, coal scam, Commonwealth scam, all the scams which were the evidences of the routine tales of corruption during the democratic governments. So dear students, that these are the following points which are the basis of the measuring democracy, and these are the actual outcomes which we read here or discuss here. So today we discuss the chapter 7, that what is democracy, why democracy is a better form of government, and how do we assess democracy's outcomes, how democracy is known as the responsive, accountable and legitimate government, and what are the measuring points of a democracy, a democratic government, and what are the real outcomes of democratic government. Next, in the next lecture, we will discuss the political outcome, social outcome, economic outcomes of democracy. Thank you and have a nice day.